They say men don't talk about their problems. They say men bottle it all up. They say this is down to some macho code and manliness that ignores hurt and pain. We say they are wrong. We say the problem is no one has been listening. In 1886, Ernest Bedford Bax of England wrote his first major commentary on gerocentrism and misandry. The 1890s seen the formation of the New York Alumni Club, a group of men that asked for access to children and that payments to an ex-wife be set at a rate that did not render these men homeless. In 2014, groups like Fathers for Justice and Dads Matter are still asking. When men do come forward to speak, we are told to bring good news stories. Unfortunately, we have an understanding that bringing good news stories will not solve the problems that men face. Problems like 98% of all war dead are men. 95% of homeless are men. 90% of workplace fatalities are men. These facts have caused a silent scream that is the ever-increasing male suicide rate. 80% of all suicides are men. The only solution to these problems that society has proffered so far has been to say, get a big straw and suck it up. Well, we are here to tell you, we are done with the straw. Men's rights is the radical notion that men are people too. We have the strange belief that services should be provided based on need, not gender. The global men's rights movement believe that a false rape allegation is as serious in America as it is in Australia or France or Northern Ireland. We are here to engage with government bodies and service providers. We are a diverse group of human beings that have transcended all typical barriers of gender, colour, class or creed to work together for men and boys. The question is, are governments now ready to join us and become part of the solution? I hereby call upon the Northern Ireland Assembly and governments worldwide to implement the following measures. 1. Create and maintain shelters for male victims of domestic abuse to the same standard and frequency as those currently provided for women. 2. Make 50-50 shared parenting the default starting point in all contested custody cases. 3. Disbar all allegations of abuse or neglect from family courts unless they have first been proven in a court of law. 4. Vigorously pursue all cases of parental alienation and prosecute those who are found guilty. Court orders for access to children can no longer be ignored. 5. Introduce a means-tested benefit that ensures all people retain at least 70% of their earnings during the period between separation and divorce. 6. Recognise the debt owed by society to veterans and implement the covenant in full. 7. Remove the word female from all genital mutilation legislation and protect all people. Removing one third of the skin from a baby's genitals is barbaric and it is unacceptable. This list is far from conclusive and should merely be seen as a starting point for those of you who truly wish to work together for men and boys. 42. On behalf of Men's Rights Northern Ireland, part of the global men's rights movement, we await your response.